Hello and welcome to FF News' coverage of ITC DIA Europe. And here today for MAPFRE, I'm Doug McKenzie, and joining me here today are two guests. Well, we've got Carlos Cendra from MAPFRE and also Lorenzo from Deal Room. Lorenzo, thank you so much for joining us here today. How are you doing? You good?
All good.
Yeah? Absolutely brilliant. And Lorenzo, could you please tell our viewers a bit more about yourself and your role at Deal Room, please?
Yeah, so Deal Room is a global data platform on startup, venture capital, and tech ecosystem. So our role is, let's say, be a data provider, being transparency to the different actors in this ecosystem. Particularly myself, I'm more involved in the research that we do. Yeah. So I've been leading our activities in insurtech and fintech. And so, for instance, it's the third year that we are working on this insurtech report. So to try to bring a bit of the hard figures, the quantitative part, and then to couple that with a bit of qualitative insights from startup, insurer, and other actors in the market.
That's absolutely amazing. I'm really excited to kind of get beyond that report and find out what your, you know, some of the findings were. But having that level of data insights is so important in such an industry. But before we go into that, yeah. Carlos, thank you as well so much for having me here today at MAPFRE's booth. How are you doing?
Very good. Thank you very much.
Well, Carlos, could you also tell the viewers here today a bit more about yourself and your role at MAPFRE?
Yeah, for sure. I'm part of the MAPFRE Open Innovation Team, which is our corporate and global scheme of innovation. And I myself, my role is I'm the leader for scouting and investment. So I'm kind of the closest guy in the company to startups out there.
That's absolutely amazing to be able to have such a brilliant organization that can also focus on the little organizations to the mid-sized organizations, really bring that exciting kind of flavor to insurance. Now, guys, you've just come off a talk about the global state of insurtech. Take me through it. What was some of, you know, what was the reasoning behind it? What were some of the key kind of discussion points? Carlos, if I could come to you first.
Yeah, sure. I mean, he's the one with the data.
Okay.
So I'm going to say the general part of it.
Yeah?
We've been doing this report. This is the third one. Yeah. We at MAPFRE, we participate in investing in startups financially via Alma Mundi Ventures, which is a verticalized insurtech fund. And the LPs of this fund get together, and with Deal Room, we prepare this report, trying to understand what is happening out there, what are the trends that are relevant, and how the ecosystem is moving. Where should we be looking at, you know, when it comes both to insurance lines, to it is distribution, it is claims, it is, I mean, what is happening there with startups. And also last year it was just Europe. This year we went global because we wanted to understand, you know, the different poles of attraction for investment and the movement of the startups down there.
I think that's such an important thing to do because every ecosystem is so different, but not one area holds the perfect key to it, you know, innovation. So brilliant. I also want to find out then, you know, if you could, Lorenzo, you could tell us a bit more about some of the findings from the report. What surprised you, if we stick with that one first?
Yeah, so let's say starting basic, we weren't surprised to see a slowdown. Everyone knows that. So I will not get too hard on that. So of course, insurtech has been slowing down a bit more than other sectors, something like that. When we analyze the figures, it's always surprising to see that, you know, there have been so disillusionment on the first wave of insurtech, the direct to consumer, consumer lines, big markets, and so on, and to see that the revenue multiple went down so much. But it's also nice to see that something we really spent some time looking into and felt a bit surprising. We discussed a lot this today is the M&A side. Because, you know, you think funding is slowing down, especially one key aspect is that usually startup plan for like 2 years of I have cash and then I need to raise, you know? Yeah. And so if we think about the downturn, it was ending in like starting in beginning of 2022. So we are like 1 year and a half of our downturn. Yeah. And so you are starting to see this discussion about, do you have cash? Do you raise again? Do you go for M&A and so on? And so we said, okay, so who's acquiring? And we said, maybe also insurers are acquiring. And then that wasn't really happening so much. apart from Luco news that came out just the other day. And so we went a bit, you know, with insights from MAPFRE, from Enron Generali, and so why, what do you see, why do you think that? And yeah, that was a really interesting discussion.
I can imagine. And Carlos, you know, from MAPFRE's perspective, was there anything that surprised you where you're like, oh, that's so interesting that maybe one geography is doing a certain trend? You know, what was exciting for you?
I have to say that it has not, it is not that close to MAPFRE, even though we do have business there, but it did surprise me. Germany's position during this first half of the year,
yeah,
because I mean, historically, the big insurtech polls in Europe have been UK, yeah, then France, and then Germany.
Yeah.
But this year, Germany is not there.
Yeah, Germany, I don't want to shoot on it. But like, I don't know, there's some slowdown. While France is going well. Yeah,
France is going
big
well.
One. Yeah.
And there are small players, yeah, Italy, Estonia. There are a couple of players,
yeah,
you know,
Spain,
with a bit more of... Spain is close,
yeah,
but
yeah,
not that...
This year that, started well. Let's yeah, see. Let's see how it goes.
Let's see what happens. And then, of course... we have a lot of business in Latin America,
yeah,
so for us it was very interesting to go on a global perspective, yeah, not just an European one. And it is true that there's a slowdown,
yeah,
and in terms of percentage it's quite big, but that's because we come from a very high peak,
yeah,
something that had never happened there. So I think the ecosystem is moving, new funds are establishing there, very well-known people coming from places like SoftBank. When you say SoftBank, everyone you know throws the red carpet.
Yeah.
So people that was there is going to LATAM and
yeah,
focusing there, opening funds to, you know, to develop
yeah,
the region. I think those are good news.
This is yeah, absolutely brilliant to hear. And it seems like the insurance industry, as you mentioned, there are so many new players, so many new geographies that are really coming up. Like you've, as you mentioned, France has overtaken the UK on investment. And it seems like it's the perfect time to have done that global look. Now, speaking of that, we're here today at ITC DIA Europe. And you guys have just come off the talk where you've been able to discuss the report. You've had such key speakers here from Generali, Stefano Bisogno. And can you tell us, you know, how was the talk? You know, was there anything that came out of the talk that, you know, really kind of followed your perspective that stuck out to you as it was, yeah, this was definitely where the industry is heading.
Yeah, no, so like what we have been saying, and I really, we believe in that, is of course there's a bifurcation in the market,
yeah,
when you get in the hard times. So, you know, some will run out of cash, some will fail, but then the quality is quality, you know.
Yeah.
Those players will still find, you know, their value, be recognized, find funding and so on. So we are definitely seeing that. And of course, this also signals, you know, for early stage startup, the situation is still easier than late stage, you know. Late stage was the big players are the ones targeting a bit more. So like, there's still a lot of capital if you are really doing something good, differentiating with the right business model. And we all believe that. Yeah, so that definitely. And on the other side, yeah, insurers, I have a more longer-term vision, of course, on how they want to develop and innovate their business. And this, of course, there's been a little bit of disillusionment, but they still believe a lot in the potential of startup. They had some years in which they learned some lessons, they improved their approach to the startup. Maybe some few more people in the organization now have a bit of better understanding of the what the startups are about, what
yeah,
they're doing in insurtech. So, you know, the bubble, of course, is creating a bit of problem of trust, whatever, but it also was something that brought insurtech to be known, because
yeah,
without those billion pouring in, maybe the big player wouldn't have looked so much from the start to it. And now they learned, and now we can maybe build something more durable, more stable
yeah,
with these two players, yeah.
Definitely, it's been a time where we can focus on actually creating sustainable companies, and as a result, reducing risk is all about what insurance is about. So that's absolutely brilliant to hear. And as we're saying, we're at ITC DIA Europe. You know, how's it been for you, Carlos? You know, have you had a great time? What's excited you the most?
It has. It has, because, well, as you can see, we are not in a regular stand.
No, it's
beautiful. At an event,
yeah,
this space, we've been working a lot in it. And yeah, we want, I mean, we're an innovation department. We wanted to do something different. So we decided not to go with the regular stand, but putting together this TV set, you know, and create some content and talk to relevant people in the ecosystem. You were just talking to Sabine van der Linden just a few moments ago. And we are sharing this with our community, Deals Room community, FF News community. So it's been vibrant. We've been doing a lot of things, you know, from preparing this to recording and then distributing. But a lot of people have stepped by, and we were just talking, you know, because we were at the panel. One of the greatest things of these places is that you can talk to people that is living the same things that you are. Because innovation is very nice to talk about it, but it has a lot of frustration on the way. There are many things that fail. Yeah. It's okay. And I mean, we are the part of the business that is allowed to fail.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make it less frustrating, you know. You so
it's a lesson in failing fast and then immediately changing your path, to, you know, to the path of success, right?
For sure. And yeah, talking to these big guys and then generally and discuss openly in that in front of an audience that we all make mistakes and that we try to learn from them. It's quite awesome.
Amazing. Guys, thank you so much for your time. It's been such a pleasure, Lorenzo.
Pleasure,
Carlos. Thank you so much, guys. It's a pleasure. Thank you.